Romo fell all the way from the top to the floor, and now Simmons taking advantage of the situation. Gosh, he viciously rammed Animal's head into that steel ring barricade. Animal is the man that they have selected now to work on. It would be obvious. And they are street fighting right now, Gordon.
They are indeed, and at the moment it's the Road Warriors getting the worst of it.
Referee Mike Atkins having a little trouble restraining Hawk. Hawk has had trouble people restraining him all his life. He's not establishment, let's say.
That's precisely correct.
Strength of Reed dropping Animal, who weighs well over 300 pounds right off the top ring cable. Steel cable inside that rubber casing.
Putting the most powerful muscles of the body across that neck and driving him further into those ring ropes. Animal's got to be having some trouble breathing now.
Big Animal being double teamed by Reed and Simmons, the team known as Doom. Double elbow. They're using that referee's count for all they can muster. And there is a lateral press. Will he pin him? No. Whoa, power out. A lot of strength left in that body. He can be hurt and have more strength than a normal human. Uh-oh, he's underneath that cable. Whoa, snaps that neck.
Again, that can adversely affect the vertebrae.
Capacity crowd here in Rainesville, Alabama, on their feet, cheering the Road Warriors on. Simmons going for it all.
Ooh,
he got kicked right in the face.
Man. He crossed his running lights that time.
He certainly did. Ellering trying to tell Hawk, or tell Animal rather, to make the tag. But the look of the legs, Simmons got the legs tied up. Animal cannot reach his partner. But Butch Reed did reach Animal with that elbow and now crawls right on top. Street style.
Pounding right hands into the side of the jaw. And I'll tell you what, it looks to me like Doom is taking all of their frustrations out on the Road Warriors.
Well, we're seeing exactly the prolific style of Doom with a high impact move. Reed drops the elbow. This will be all. He kicked out. I want to tell you, anybody else would have been beat right there.
No question about that. Just tremendous reflex action. And Animal fired two desperation shots to the midsection.
I'll tell you something, the Road Warriors got a lot of gut to sign a match of this magnitude, knowing it's going to be this physical 48 hours before they're going to step into the skyscrapers in Greensboro Sunday night.
Yeah, I question the wisdom of that, but again, this is at the hands of Paul Ellering. He's got something up his sleeve.
You know, you play the best in big games when you play the best leading into them. That's what the college football coaches say. Basketball the same way. You want to play the best teams early to prepare for the playoffs. And indeed, the playoffs, the Super Bowl of wrestling is this Sunday night in Greensboro.
Question is, will the skyscrapers or the Road Warriors become Denver?
That's a very good question. Who's going to be John Elway Sunday? Again, referee Mike Atkins putting Hawk out, and it gives the Doom a great opportunity to double team. He'll use his count now, but it's really too late.
Come on, that's it.
This should be it. One, two, and he's got the shoulder up, but he's not powering out like he was moments ago in these near fall situations. Animal is becoming much more weakened.
He is indeed, but I'll tell you what, I think the Doom, Simmons and Hacksaw Butch Reed have fired their best salvos.
Out of desperation, the Animal with a well-placed kick. And he's in the corner, but he didn't make the tag. He was close to making the tag. Reed, that power slam. Adrenaline is flowing. Reed is elevated. Here comes that net breaker. What an awesome move from an awesome athlete. Reed sent for the ride. Powerful shoulder block. Hall goes to the lateral press. But Simmons kicks him in the back of the head. And now all four men in this tag team event are in the ring.
We've got our own miniature Chicago street fight right here.
We're talking to Reed, the legal man, I believe. Hawk tossed outside. And now Simmons going up. Hawk right behind him. Hawk sends him right off. Big move from the top, and this will do it. The Road Warriors have won it.
Poor wrestling fans, here are your winners, Evelyn Hawk, Road Warriors.
What a hard fought victory. Just 48 hours before WrestleWar.
And here is where Simmons is coming up. Ellering has told Hawk to move in on him. Hawk gives him that one little belt. And now it's Hawk's opportunity to mount that top as the animal teamed up. But the key factor in this match, I believe, was the precious Paul Ellering, his leadership on the team. And so the Road Warriors do emerge victorious in this event.
And we'll be right back on the Power.
TBS and the Power Hour. Don't forget to join us tomorrow night, this Saturday night, 6:05 for World Championship Wrestling. And fans, this week's Wrestler of the Week, good old Norman, the fans, the kids' favorite, Norman, the Wrestler of the Week. Gordon, I want to tell the fans about this Saturday night's big show on World Championship Wrestling. The World's Strongest Man, Doug Furness, will be there. We'll have an update on the United States Tag Team Title Tournament. But I want to ask you your comments. You've been around a lot of NWA World Championship matches, and this Sunday night, when Luger meets Flair, don't you have a feeling somewhere down deep that Flair's a little apprehensive to wrestle Lex Luger?
I think he's totally apprehensive, Jim. I'll tell you what, Luger made a very good point when he said that Flair has always kept himself surrounded by people. Now, of course, he's surrounded by a woman. Here's somebody who has never interfered in a match. However, as desperate as Flair may be, we may be seeing there. And I smell not an upset in the making. Because if Luger defeats Flair, it's not an upset, because this man is a superbly conditioned athlete whose time may have come.
And we saw last Saturday the Horseman try to get to Lex Luger, but he finally abated the situation, and he's healed up quite well, as a matter of fact. He will be at 100% this Sunday night, 7 o'clock. And as Gordon said earlier in the program, you still have time to call your local cable company, and we hope you'll do so. For Gordon Solie, ladies and gentlemen, I'm Jim Ross. Thanks very much for being with us. And we hope you'll see us tomorrow night at 6:05 on World Championship Wrestling.